Good morning, everybody. Welcome to another Daily Mark Report brought to you by Mike Bjork. Today is Monday and it's February 13th. Hope you guys had a great weekend here. There's nothing on the economic calendar today, so it'll be kind of probably a fairly quick one here today. I don't want to let you guys move on with your day here. Headline news, again, it's kind of the stock market's up. The Dow's been up over 100 so far this morning, and it's still kind of taking its cue from the President Trump. Basically, that there's been a couple of different things on there. One, of course, he's still talking about the tax plan that hasn't been rolled out yet, so we don't know the details of it. But they're, again, feeling a bit optimistic about where things could go, especially with the economy, what it could potentially do for the economy here with the tax breaks, especially on corporations. They can reinvest that money, hire more people. You know, it could do a lot of good for the economy and really kind of get it instead of this very flatline economy we've been moving over the last quite a few years since the credit crisis. We could probably see a bit more of a spike in the economy, which would obviously therefore increase inflation here as a result. Also, he's been meeting with Japan and China. It seems like the investors feel that he's been kind of softening his stance with them, and relationships, U.S. relationships with those two countries seem to be a little bit better than maybe in the beginning, since a lot of rhetoric's been going around. And then he's also going to be talking about NAFTA. So he sounds like he's going to be meeting up with Prime Minister Trudeau to talk about common ground and maybe replacing NAFTA with another agreement here as well. Another thing that could make the markets a little volatile over these next 2 days, Fed member Janet Yellen, she's chairman. She's meeting today in front of the Senate Banking Committee, and then tomorrow she's going to be meeting in front of the House tomorrow and testifying before the House. And of course, any comments that comes up throughout the both meetings could move markets in either direction. So far, the stock market's liking what she says, as you'll see coming up how it'll affect the bond market. But again, depending on what she says, it could anything that surprises the markets, you could see obviously a quick sudden turn to a different direction here. Speaking of bond markets, here we are. Here's where we left. We did leave off Friday basically unchanged. We started the day off much lower, even tested the 50-day moving average, and basically settled on the 25-day moving average. This morning, we did move lower. We're down about, earlier was it even as low as 19 basis points, but right now about 15 basis points, right about at the 15-day moving, or I'm sorry, at the 50-day moving average, which basically puts us at the lower end of the spectrum, but also testing that floor. Hopefully that floor supports us and keeps us there above that. So if we break below that, then I'd be very cautious, and because we could have another run lower, which would raise interest rates. But interest rates did go up as a result of from Friday's, as we did lower about 15-19 basis points so far this morning, depending on what lenders came out with their pricing. So as a result of that, this is something we want to watch on. So if we can rebound from that, we could we could still stay above this trading range here we've been kind of experiencing with this recent improvements, since we haven't really seen these since about the middle of November. All right, folks. But if you guys want to get more data throughout the day, I do post on Twitter. Just come underneath Mike Bjork. Feel free to come over to Twitter and get your daily updates. Have a wonderful day. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye.